Hi, I'm Dylan with Mastercam, and in this video, I want to show you how we can quickly apply 5-axis accelerated finishing paths to an existing project. I've already programmed this sorting slider with a traditional finish path using a ball endmill, and I've settled on a step over of 0.5 millimeters to produce the desired finish. To reduce the total cut time, I've identified the faces on the model that'll be good candidates for accelerated finishing, and I've marked them in green. After launching Dynamic from the Analyze group on the Home tab, I'll inspect a few of these surfaces. I can see the minimum radius curvature is roughly 42 millimeters. With that information, I'm going to select the Lens Form tool with a 25 millimeter effective radius and add it to my tool library. To start, I'll machine the side faces with a basic parallel 5-axis toolpath. I'll select these surfaces as the drive geometry and set the passes to be parallel to the front face. To get a good finish, I want to keep all the passes going in the same direction. Now I need to decide on my step over and tool axis control strategy. The goal here is to take advantage of the large effective cutting radius to achieve the same cusp height I would get with a standard ball endmill, but with far fewer passes. With my original 4mm ball endmill, a step over of 0.5 millimeters was producing cusps of 0.016 millimeters. With the Lens Form tool, I can increase the step over to 1.8 millimeters and retain the same cusp height. This means far fewer passes are needed to finish these surfaces, which is going to save a lot of time at the machine. Just like a ball endmill, we need to keep the tool tilted during machining to make sure that we're machining with a large radius. For this tool, 5 degrees of lead and tilt should be enough to establish a good contact patch along the tool nose. In my linking parameters, I'm going to set up some smooth transition motion for the one-way passes. I'll adjust the small gap behavior and size, and then change my lead in and lead out to a vertical arc. With the parameters set, I can generate the toolpath and look at the motion in backplot. 5 degrees of lead and tilt worked well, and I'm staying within the effective radius on the tool, but I want to change the cut order and direction to get the type of cut I want. I'll go back into the cut parameters, and under sorting, I'll enable flip step over. It's important to note that climb versus conventional is dependent on which way the tool is tilted. So in this case, we're not switching to conventional milling, but instead changing the cut direction. With these changes made, I can regenerate the toolpath and review it in backplot. The tool motion looks great. So now I can apply the same technique to the center surfaces. For this toolpath, I'll change my strategy to stay parallel to the side face instead. This allows me to take advantage of the tool tilt to get as close as I can to the center of the V with my finish passes. We'll generate this toolpath and take a look in backplot. The motion is pretty good, but I'm violating the adjacent surfaces with the final passes near the center of the V. To avoid this gouge, we're going to need to add an additional collision control strategy. I'll tell Mastercam to change the side tilt angle of the tool based on the center fillet and adjacent surfaces. Now, if I regenerate the toolpath and review it in backplot, the tool is correctly tilting away to avoid violating those surfaces. Now that I'm happy with both toolpaths, I can program the opposite side with the same strategy. By applying accelerated finishing to just a few faces on this part, I've reduced the total runtime of the finished toolpaths by approximately 30%. That's a great time savings for even a single part, but if this was part of a large production run, the savings in machine time and tool life would be a game changer.